Okay, so in this video, I'm going to show you steps number 49 and 50 and 51, and I'm going to show you another step that's going to come after step 49. So the next step you're going to do is you're going to work on closing up this pocket. So make sure that this is your right side of the fabric. These are your side pieces. Make sure the side pieces are coming together like that. And then you're gonna take the pocket. So it comes, flips over here, and you're basically gonna put these sides together like so. And pin those together. And we're gonna sew a 5/8 seam down the center here. This is a little bit different than what the directions tell you to do, just because I want to finish, I want this to be a finished edge and all, and you'll see in a few minutes how that's going to look. But we're going to sew a 5/8 seam now. Make sure. The last step we did was we moved the needle. So make sure that your needle is right smack in the center with this dial right here. So make sure that, this dial in the center is in the center. So your needle will be in the center. Now, this extra step that I'm going to show you is a type of seam finish. This is called bias tape, and it's cut on the bias, and it won't stretch anymore. So you're going to, it's folded like this, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to pin this on this over this raw edge seam here and pin that in place, and then I'm going to stitch close to the edge, and that's going to finish off this edge. Unfortunately, bias tape doesn't come in a lot of colors, so you just have to try to find something that would match the closest. There's probably a deeper red in bias tape, but I just had this color on hand, so it's not going to be seen anyway. So it's just the purpose, the reason why we're doing this is we're just finishing off this edge so that when we wash this, that raw edge won't ravel on us. And bias tape comes in like different folds, like double fold, single fold, and different widths, and all. And you can find that in like Joann Fabrics, Walmart, I believe, carries it as well. And also Hobby Lobby. Okay, so now I'm just going to trim that little excess off there. And those are not working, so we'll try this one. All right, so now I'm just going to stitch close to that edge. Now that finished off that edge there, and I'm going to go to the iron and I'll press that close there. So now that you've got this all finished, you're going to flip it. So it's like this. So now you've created your pocket there. And this side is the inside of the pocket. So when you put your hands in the pocket, you won't feel this raw edge. You'll have a nice finished edge inside the pocket there. So now what they want you to do is they want the next step, which is step number 50. We're gonna stitch this top edge closed. Okay, so, but you want to only stitch this cotton fabric. Don't stitch it to the fleece fabric. It has to be free. So as you can see, I'm pinning this away from the fleece. So now our pocket, like if we bend over, the stuff in our pocket won't fall out. And we're gonna pin this top up here. And I'm folding this seam over like that. All right, now when you get ready to stitch this, you gotta be careful not to stitch it to the fleece. It's gonna have, you're only stitching the fabric. And let's see. We're gonna go ahead and stitch a 5/8 because I don't think it tells us. Nope, just we're gonna stitch a 5/8. So I'm gonna start in the seam here. And make sure your edges are together. Do is we're going to do a seam finish, a zigzag seam finish on this. You could do the bias tape, but I won't have enough for everybody. So we're just going to do a zigzag seam finish. So what I'm doing is I'm going to put the edge of the foot to where my edge of my stitching is and move this outer dial to 2. So then there's that. Okay, and then the next step, which is step number 50, what they're wanting you to do is just match your seams here, match your edges, and then you're gonna pin the pocket to the fleece. In the pocket to the fleece, and then you're going to hand baste the pocket to the front of the fleece. So I went ahead and made a single thread and knotted it. And I'm just gonna do hand basting close to this edge here. So it's about like that far, if you can see my needle. So I'm gonna just do kind of a running stitch here. So we'll go down and up, and we'll go down and up, just like that. And it's turning out to be an even basting stitch. Watch out for your double. You don't want to be a double. You want it to stay a single. So it's basically just hand sewing and basting that in place. Just going down and up, down and up. And then my last one here, down and up. And then I'll just knot that off. Make a lasso, put your finger here and pull the thread through your nail, and then clip. All right, and that's step number. Okay, it should look something like that. And that's step 51.